fundamental to transport a sick patient, especially cardiac patients with defibrillator facility and all. The sudden cardiac death is not a new thing. It is known for centuries, and this is the program realizing the impact of this disease. The Central Health Administrative Authorities have allocated in the National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, Cardiovascular Disease and Strokes, and to the tune of 8,000 crores were spent in the past 5 years. It is not only the money, more important is the awareness of the disease and to provide accessibility of medical health services, especially in the rural population, in a country where urban-rural divide plays a significant role in the health care. When we started the hospital here about 35 years ago, after having qualified from All India Institute, we were not having even ventilators, and it was very, very difficult to treat the chest pain patients and heart attack patients. To make the diagnosis, to do any aggressive investigations like interventions, and the deficit was obviously visible, and many patients were dying on the way to Hyderabad when we were shifting them. Having even ventilators and so though it is known, with the sudden demise of these apparently healthy looking people, now it has become almost a lot of awareness, and people want to know what is the cause. Earlier people were thinking, okay, I'm 40, I'm 50, nothing will happen to me. Now people know that they should have at least awareness so that they can follow some lifestyle measures. And heart attacks do not happen suddenly overnight. The disease is there for almost 20 to 30 years. The plaque starts in some unfortunate people who are genetically prone, and this plaque suddenly, for several reasons which are known and unknown, suddenly ruptures and it blocks the vessel. It is not very easy to diagnose when it is only 30 to 40% stenosis. One of the basic purposes of this CME is to create awareness that majority of the heart attacks occur in patients with 30 to 40% stenosis, not 70 to 80% stenosis. This fundamental fact, if it is realized and it doesn't produce any symptoms. And the Indian patients, apart from having a lot of risk factors, the most important risk factor is the low quality of cardiovascular care. That is the most important risk factor. And the young people, the affection, and that is the main cause of concern. And coronary artery disease, of all sudden cardiac disease, coronary artery disease is the main cause. And these are the stalwarts, having realized the impact of CAD on public health, and people have contributed lot of scientific research data, how to move forward and how to prevent heart attacks and sudden cardiac death. And these are the visionaries who trained me and thousands of people like me in Delhi, in All India Institute and G.B. Pant Hospital. And the honorees, these three names are household in Telugu states. And probably many people, their parents or their grandparents must have got in touch to have a diagnosis or, you know, to have the advice of these great people. Once we started, we focused on three major things. One is quality. how to provide quality services to the patients and transparency, and how to have the technology. Vijayawada being two-tier or three-tier city, it was very difficult to have technology and the people who are trained. And but however, people gave us, trusted us, and it allowed us to create facility in the neighboring four districts. And fortunately, with the help of many of the physicians sitting here who supported us, and when we started this cath lab, Dr. Somaraju's team, who and Dr. Prasad Raja gave us a lot of encouragement, and that is the basis for us and foundation now to become or to create a sort of have a milestone here. The second was academic program. This was another focus, and almost for the past 9 years we have this DNB program, and now we have almost 20 DNB students. The third one is research. We have been into research since 2004, and we have participated in almost 28 the research studies which are approved by the FDA, and almost every molecule which is used in cardiology practice, we were part of the that particular study. And most of the Indian patients, how they behave, because most of the times we depend on the Western data, so we have this, and this is how we achieved this 50,000 mark. And this is not a simple achievement, it is because of the people around us who have been working day and night with passion. Many sleepless nights all these people have spent to achieve this. And this is the cardiothoracic team existing. Not only the existing team, people were going to peripheries, and they were staying till 3 o'clock in the night to see the OPDs and coming back. So these are the people who are going there. And then these are the, almost about 100 consultants have participated to achieve this, and these people have now working somewhere else. Yeah, another is technology. We have telemedicine, tele-ICU, tele-ER, tele-ambulance, and 4G ambulance now. So we can monitor our all patients across the cluster, Guntur, Ongole, Vijayawada, all patients 24/7 through our central command station. We can have a live also. And the other important is the training programs which we have been giving, conducting seminars, IMA meetings since 1997, and we have conducted national and international workshops with the STEMI India, and also the Telemedicon International Festival, and all these things. These are all our passion, and this made us to update our knowledge and also try to disseminate whatever is there and update what are the latest guidelines and these factors. So with this, we think that the Andhra Pradesh people have given us, the physicians, and a lot of support we had from, and we rededicate. And in fact, we got even, because of the quality we have, patients from Tanzania, from Pakistan, we have operated on these patients. And then our telemedicine in the airport helped to save this Belgian patient from airport. We picked up and did the angioplasty for this patient. So with all these things, we are very happy to be here. And the basic purpose of the CME in the afternoon session, we will be seeing. The idea is the cardiology practice has changed in the past 5 years. It is not this old cardiology where you refer to the cardiologist just to know whether the patient has got disease or not. It is you can diagnose the mild and moderate disease, and you can treat, and critical cases can be sent to the cardiologist. So with this, and then you can use telemedicine in your practice to save lives, and then the proper screening of cascade screening of hypertension, hyperlipidemia, diabetes, all these things, if you do properly, there is huge scope to prevent sudden cardiac death, predict the disease, prevent the disease progression, and this is the